Here's how you can render videos in Sony Vegas that are optimized for size, quality, and rendering speed. There are a lot of rookie mistakes people make in Sony Vegas, but if you follow my instructions, you'll be fine. It's good to record everything in the same format you'll be rendering it in. Aside from 4K resolution videos, YouTube accepts heights of 144, 240, 360, 480, 720, and 1080 natively. Anything else will be scaled, which you don't want, and only 720 and 1080p are considered HD. It's best to make sure your original clips are either 720 or 1080. YouTube's maximum frame rate at this time is 30 frames per second, so let's assume that you're working with that. If not, your video will turn out with blurry motion unless you disable resampling on your video. To do that, right-click on the clip in the project and select Disable Resample. To double-check your clip's original frame rate and resolution, click the Media tab and take a look at Attributes and Frame Rate. Also, do the same thing for the audio in your project to see its sample rate. Next, open up your project's properties by going to File and clicking Properties. The width and height should be the same as your video clip, as well as the frame rate. Field order should always be none, and pixel aspect ratio should always be 1. Moving down, it's essential to have your pixel format set to 32-bit floating point full range. If it's not set to this and you use the main concept renderer, your video will turn out too contrasted and will be almost unwatchable. You'll also need to turn View Transform off. Lastly, move over to the Audio tab and make sure the sample rate is the same as your input clip. It's going to either be 44.1 or 48 kHz most of the time. Make sure to save these settings as a preset if you expect to render more videos like this. Just click the disk icon after giving it an appropriate name. To render your video, open the Render As dialog under File. In order to have the same options listed in this tutorial, you'll need Sony Vegas Pro. Specifically, I use the Main Concept Renderer, which is really great for rendering YouTube videos if you know what you're doing, like me. After following my instructions, you will too. Once you've selected Main Concept AVC AAC, choose either Internet HD 720 or 1080p. You'll be modifying this to take advantage of YouTube's recommended settings listed in their Advanced Encoding Help page, which I'll link in the description. So click on the preset, then go to Customize Template. Make sure the resolution is the same as your input clip. You can also let the source adjust it, but I prefer setting it myself. The profile should be set to high. The frame rate should also be the same as the project's, which in turn should be the same as your input clip. Field order should be none, pixel aspect 1, reference frames 2. Now here's where it gets a bit iffy and opinions differ. YouTube will always compress your video after you upload it, no matter what. Therefore, your input should be as high quality as possible. If you look at the Advanced Encoding Settings page, there are recommended bit rates for different resolutions, as well as those for ones with good connections or a lot of extra time and patience. I've found the best settings for 1080p are with an average of 25 megabits or 25 million bits here, and a maximum of 50 megabits. You can turn the maximum up really high, and it'll make the video a little bit larger, but complex parts of the video will retain their quality better. Before setting the encode mode, go to the System tab. Click Check GPU to see if your GPU supports CUDA or OpenCL. Remember what it says here. Going back to the Video tab, select which one your system supports. Lastly, go to the Audio tab and set the sample rate to what your project and source media is, and the bitrate to 384 if your video is stereo. If it's mono or 5.1, make sure to look at YouTube's Advanced Encoding page to see what the other recommendations are. If you have a lot of GPU power or extra time, you can make your render a 2-pass, which takes twice as long, but your video's quality will be improved by this a bit. Click the Save icon after naming your preset. Now render your project and watch in awe as it goes much quicker than the default settings. It still takes ages for HD videos, but the end result is usually a very acceptable size with great quality, and it looks awesome when you upload it to YouTube. Let's see how my clip turned out.